what's shaking? It's Alexa Layton, and here on Music Mondays, we don't f around. It's season 3, bitches, so if we go hard, y'all gotta go hard too. So check out this week's new heat because the competition is getting fierce. I need you, you come around. Come around. Without you, I'm empty. You hold it down. From me to you, they ain't seeing you. Body shape slow, smooth, they ain't mean as you. I could pull up, just let me know if I'm seeing you. We could take over the world, baby, just me and you. Brand new ball, man's got a few in it. All this dirty money, I'm the new Diddy. I may fuck your bitch if she cool with it. I so foul with I'm. I've been whipping work in the kitchen. Trying to get ahead, Bill Clinton. You know I gotta get the money ASAP. Get it ASAP, and that's where the Kathy Griffin. I just let it bubble in the pot.
Yo, on the rail, I'm feeling like I made a meal, that's how I feel. I'm looking like I got a deal, what's the deal? From now on, if you want the rail, to get the rail, I need a check, pay the bill, pay the bill.
All the jams.
Yeah.
Jams with Julius.
Oh, God.
Dinnerland.tv. Be safe though.
I love dinner. 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 I love dinner.
What? What?
DJ Nova what? Scotia.
What? What? What?
Like folk, but if I got you, I'ma write though. But if you not around, I'm Shaq, had to freak though shit. And I'm attached, what's the word for that? Clingy, but if you need me, I'm right there, chingy. A line for my millennium child. I love you since baggy tees was the choice of our style. But damn, time changing, look at you now, wow. Breathtaking, I hope the feeling's mutual. Look, breathtaking, you goddamn beautiful, no doubt about it. I smack a if you try to doubt it. Cause you my everything, I fight for you, take a knife for you. I walk 1,000 miles for you. What is love, 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 love? I need that, I need that. So what is love, 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 love? Hold up. And what is love, 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 love? I talk nice, huh? Talk nice. What is love, 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 love? Hold up. Yeah, yeah. Light skin, brown eyes, a bad shoulder, and she real slim. No titties and nobody, but I'm still down. Her mind was amazing, so we splitting up, but sure we talking occasion. Patient, said she needs some space and time, that maybe we could bring it back, like we press for bottom, y'all gonna fuck you. And that's some shit I wanna say, but my hubby in the way, hey, that. Hey, yo, we live from, live from the, hey, yo, we live from the dope, Joe, yo, we live.
From the dojo.
And welcome back to another week with me. On today's menu, we're going to try something very new. A bag of mixed bugs. I know what you're thinking. Jesse, that sounds bonkers! It is. Yeah. I have mixed bugs and I have a piece of bread. And that's what I call le bug sandwich. Here I have my little dinner table set up. I got my extendo fork. I don't know why, but I do. And now it's time to place the bugs on the bread. That's gross! Okay, in 3, 2, 1, bon appetit. I'm not excited about this at all. I don't want to do it. Do it, do it, do it, do it. Fuck this workshop. Well, that didn't go as planned. I lost my mustache. I hope you guys enjoyed this week's episode of Strangeland. I will see you next week with another episode on Dinnerland TV.
Sitting here just thinking about you. I want my legs wrapped all around you. Trying to
I love dinner.
I get this train rolling soon. Even if I don't quite fit like bowling shoes. I don't get sick cause I've grown immune. I don't pay attention to what it don't include.
Oh, bitch.
What's going on, y'all? Welcome to another episode of Who You With the Podcast. My name is Garnett Briscoe. Unfortunately, Vet not here today. She had to work. This is like a special event going on, man. We got a special guest in the building. This nigga's from Atlanta. This nigga raps really good. I read his tweets. He tweet good, too. You got some good tweets, bro. We got Quentin Miller in the building, man. What's going on?
Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's Quinn Miller. How y'all doing?
This nigga got a sexy voice on. Nah, so you just had a show last night in Philly, man. I really thought, like, you tore that shit down. Y'all packed that shit out, man. Real rap. You was up there with the Nike gloves and shit on, rapping hard. I was singing some of your lyrics and talking to the bitch that was next to me, man. So you... You got me some ass, man. Thank you, man. I appreciate that.
That's what's up, man.
Appreciate that. Yeah, I wasn't stroking for you, though. I was stroking for me.
You should not stroke for me. That's the way it's supposed to be.
Hopefully, y'all ain't fucked none of my bitches, man. You fucked some of my hoes last night?
Nah, man. No comment.
Oh, man.
I'm just playing. Nah, man. I'm a good kid.
All right, man. I'm just saying, don't be out here fucking out of my hoes, man.
Nah, man.
If y'all do, cause y'all came deep. If y'all do, definitely, man, wear a condom. It can't be two raw dicks and one vagina, man. I don't like that. I don't like that shit. And STDs, man, is real if you don't.
Gunmetal Grey Tour is going on right now in New York tonight. I'm not talking about the raw stuff.
Sometimes you gotta do that, man. But how the tour life, man? I know y'all coming up from Atlanta. Y'all stopped over there in Houston, like I said last night. Y'all was in Philly, and then tonight y'all up in New York, man. So how tour life treat you?
It's cool. I appreciate it. It's like I feel like every artist has been at this stage before, and I'm appreciating the grind.
Right.
You know, like, it's like putting my team together, you know, like really seeing who's who and what's what. Like, right. It's a beautiful thing. It's a beautiful, beautiful
thing. You see a lot of fake people starting to want to be around? Or are you pretty good at weeding that out?
Yeah, I'm pretty, my circle's kind of tight, you know, and it's pretty much been the same folks, you know, for a minute. So, you know, as far as, you know, outsiders or whatnot, you know, you deal with them accordingly, but. You know, everything's pretty good, man.
What song you think is like the most receptive as far as like when you out there performing? Like I said, last night was fucking lit. It was a packed house.
Yeah.
So like, what song you feel like you connect with the people a little bit more?
Potential seems to turn shit up.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah, it's different in different areas though. Like, but I don't know, people connect with Potential. I guess girls really do like guys with potential. You know, it's a lot of guys out there that feel like they got it, so I don't know.
That's a little scary though, to try to date somebody with potential, because you seeing them further than they might even see themselves.
Yeah.
So
I mean I feel like with a lot of girls, which you ain't got no choice.
Right.
I mean, unless you just got options of ballers.
Well,
you gonna have to find that one that you feel like he gonna be something one day.
These bitches do got options of ballers thanks to Instagram.
Of course, they're a like away from
Tristan Thompson or somebody, man. They're a like away.
But then, you know, you get you a baller or something, and he might not appreciate you the right way.
Yeah, that always happens. And that's when they always come back to a local nigga like me. I don't go on tour, so I'm here. That's why I said I'm
let's
fucking
go
out
to
of
the
my
movies.
Bitches.
You want to get dinner tonight? I have time.
Right. I got time. Quentin Miller ain't got time for y'all, so don't try to date him. He ain't got time. But let's talk about the album a little bit, man. You got Gunmetal Grey.
Yeah.
What's the name behind that? Because when I first, you know, I clicked on it, I listened to it, I'm like, Gunmetal Grey, like this nigga packing heat. Like, what's going on?
Nah, that's... it was a color choice of my prosthetic leg. You know, the doctor said I could pick black or gunmetal gray, and you know, of course,
right.
Gunmetal gray.
It sound better,
and it just stuck with me, you know. And it was just like something I just ran with.
Right, yeah. And I feel as though you real open on the album, man. I felt like I connected with you. As far as, you know, sometimes you do be down when you're going through a lot.
Yeah.
You don't know what the hell is ahead of you.
Yeah.
But like you said, you was talking about, you know, you prosthetic and the Bapes. Yeah. I thought that was the hardest line on there.
Thank you.
That was like the hardest line on there. I'll fuck with it.
Yeah.
So like, what was the process of like making this?
I don't know. It was just experimenting, just trying to find a way to like say what I gotta say and like stand out. You know, I finished it in Seattle. It's kind of hard to explain, man. It's just like a place or a state of mind that I was in. You know, like,
right.
I, you know, the metal thing kind of correlates with like, you know, rough, like the rug, especially like shredded metal and
right.
shit too, you know. And I kind of feel like that's kind of where I am at in my career, you know, like, and it was like a rough place,
right?
You know, it just in my life in general, you know,
right.
coming off the accident and everything, like, it gave me a rough place to restart from, you know. But you know, I feel like I kind of captured it, and you know, maybe, you know, 5 years from now, you know, down the line, people will look back on it and be like, oh man, that's, it made sense with where he was
right.
at that time, you know.
I mean, for, you know, for the listeners that may not know, you got into a pretty, you know, bad car accident.
Yeah.
Unfortunate things happen, like you said. You now have a prosthetic leg and shit.
Yeah.
But you know, did you ever struggle with like your faith during those times?
Nah, I just struggle with sitting down for so fucking long because I'm just, yeah. I don't like to just sit around. I'm not like one of those dudes. And, you know, unfortunately, when you go through something like that, you have to wait and allow your body time to heal up before you can even get to the next stage of waiting for the leg and shit, you know. So I think that was patience. That was the hardest part because I was just like, man, I'm ready to get back out there, you know. But you know, it all worked out.
So. Nah, like I said, I personally, I thought the album was dope. Like I saw the performance, that made it even better. So you know, for the people that's listening, definitely go download, go buy that Gunmetal Gray. Quentin Miller, shit is dope.
Yeah.
But so this nigga's in here playing with the lifesaver, man.
I just wanted y'all to hear that.
So who was before all of this? Like who that was Quentin Miller, man? Like who were you as a kid? Who were you, you know, before your
name? I was homeschooled, so that's what got why I got into rapping, because I just figured shit, like if I know how to do this, then maybe I'll be cool, you know?
Right.
So I kind of did it to be cool at first, and then I found myself like, oh shit, I actually really love
did
this
it work
shit, you know? It did work, you know? It didn't work like as far as in social settings, but yeah. Like if I would find myself in a situation where I get to freestyle in front of people and stuff, then they'd be like, hey Quinn, look at little Quinn, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
And for that moment I'm cool, and then I go back to being like a corny little kid.
But yeah. Well, I mean, why would you consider yourself corny? Like, as far as like you being a little kid, like,
I mean, you know, I don't know. I was homeschooled, man. I could tell. I could tell by the non-phone numbers I was getting, you know, coming up, you know. But
nah, I mean, kids definitely could be harsh. But what I say, I feel like I'm corny. I feel like everybody I chill around is corny.
Yeah.
That's just me. I feel like the cool kids, they're the real definition of corny, because they try to be somebody that they not.
Yeah, I mean, you get older and then you realize that cool is being yourself. And it's,
exactly.
It's not trying to be.
Exactly.
You know, but that's shit that you find out with experience. But
right.
Yeah, I mean, it started there, and then, you know, I was signed to Tricky Stewart and Epic Records, but that never transpired into anything. Ended up getting dropped.
What was the problem with that? Like, why do you feel like you got dropped?
Just politics, man. This is a very political high school business, and I had to learn that early, the hard way. Oh, my fault. My fault. Yeah, but politics, man.
So you said, I remember, you know, watching another interview. You was recording at Usher's house. Like, that's a big fucking deal.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
So how was your relationship with him?
We never really had a major relationship like that. I was just working with the producer that was signed to him.
Right.
At the time, a guy named Sounds.
We out here. You don't want no Jameson, bro. Like,
nah, I ain't eight, man. It's too early in the day.
So let's talk about the Quentin Miller, like right now. Like, how are the people treating you? How the ladies treating you? Like I said, like your name is. Your name now, like you walk around and people's like, oh shit, like that's Quentin Miller.
I mean, it's been an interesting experience. This is my first time like really getting out there and like touching the people, you know. Like I've been behind the computer screen just posting stuff for the longest, so it's been great, man. Like the reactions and, you know, just getting to see like my fans and people that really fuck with me. Yeah.
Nah, that gotta be a crazy, you know, experience though, because like to see that you actually like got these fans that know your songs word for word. Like you can almost hand them a mic.
That's
and be
new
like,
to me. That's brand new to me. Yeah. So thank everybody like that listens to my music. Like, yeah, it's crazy.
You ever had somebody come up to you in the club and just rap a verse for no reason? Like, yo, you gotta hear this shit. Like, I've been working on this.
You know, I had some experiences, but, you know, I'm glad people are excited.
Right, to see
me, man.
Nah, and another thing that I noticed, like, we met yesterday, man. Real humble dude. Really humble dude. Down to earth. Your team funny as hell. Mike think I'm Ethiopian from the rip. Like, man. Yeah, man. Definitely. So, like, how do you feel, like, growing up, like, shaped these humble, you know, I guess, beginnings? Like,
I'm not sure, but somehow it did.
Right.
Like, you can't choose the way you grow up.
Right. But
the way I grew up is it made me who I am. So. Right.
Yeah. Down in the A. Y'all music scene is crazy, man. Like, y'all battle New York as far as, like, where's the home of hip-hop. Like, yeah, like...
It wasn't.
Right.
Yeah.
So, like, how, like, what is the scene down here? Because up here, Philly is, like, the Philly, South Jersey area, it's, like, the middle scene. Like, it's kind of, like, dead. You have to go to New York in order to go make your moves. Luckily, we only, you know, hour and a half, 2 hours away, so it's not far. But, like, it's a real scene down in Atlanta, man. So talk about that a little bit. Like, what's going on? How come y'all got a new rapper every 3 months that just make millions of dollars, you know, independently,
it's interesting, man. Like, just, like, hearing, like, the outside perspective. But, like, growing up in Atlanta, it's, like, that's, like, normal to us, like, just the scene, like, well, at least from my perspective, right. It's just like we just always had a scene, I guess,
which is true.
But I mean, I feel like it's a little different today. I mean, I'm sure, like, you know, there, of course, there's your major cities that have their scenes, but man, with the internet, man, like, you can do what you want to do, man.
Right.
Anyway,
but even with the internet, though, it still seemed like it's Atlanta, like, that's really, like, the focal point of everything, like, even with the, like I said, the internet.
So, I mean, I think one thing that I always love about Atlanta, like, we don't care about, like, what's going on everywhere else. Like, we care, but, you know, you come to Atlanta, you listen to, like, primetime radio or whatnot, like, you'll hear local Atlanta artists, you know, right. Like, because we fuck with Atlanta, you know, like.
It's not a crab barrel.
Yeah, it's not y'all a crab barrel. Like, artists. We fuck with each other. Like,
okay.
We're not pulling each other down.
Okay.
You know, like, everybody, like, oh, that's the hard shit, and that's the hard
right,
shit.
Right, right, right.
Yeah.
If you gonna rap, you need to be about your shit.
Right.
You know, it's not like super Billboard Pop 100, you know what I'm saying? Like, right. Some other cities, you know what I'm saying? It's like, you know, of course, they play the regular, you know, hottest songs, right. But, you know.
There's only, like, one top 20 radio station.
Right.
In Atlanta. Yeah. Like, everything else is like we trying to break, and they trying to break, so they in competition with other radio stations. We trying to break, so everybody breaking.
Yeah.
And that may be, like I said, maybe the problem here a little bit, or even in New York, so to speak. I don't know. I don't really listen to a radio station. I'm not up there, but at least here, like, we're trying to, at least South Jersey, shout out the South Side, trying to build a market here.
Yeah.
But our closest radio station is Power 99 over there, man. They need them checks. You feel me? Yeah. And that's what they going off of. So what it sound like down in Atlanta, y'all don't really give a fuck about the money. Y'all just give a fuck about the music. And that's and how, like, y'all turning,
you know,
it over.
Like, no, I haven't broken the radio barrier yet.
Right.
You know? So it's not even just about the radio. It's just really just about the culture. Like Max said, it's like, it's not that crabs in a barrel. It's like, you know, 1317, we fuck with 2-9, you know what I'm saying? They fuck with Money Making Bros, you know what I'm saying? It's like, we see each other, we fuck with each other, we support each other, you know right. what I'm saying? It's like, it's not like a shice thing, you know?
Right. So. And plus, y'all, the city on fire right now, y'all said, man. Atlanta going to the Super Bowl and shit. First time since the Dirty Bird.
Super Bowl. Stop playing with me.
Yo, like, how... And it's what they just played the last game inside a dome and shit. Yeah, that shit was terrible, bro.
Not even rest in peace to the dome, because it's Georgia State now.
Right. But even with that, like, how's the energy down there based off of, you know, the football team having, like, real success right now?
It's lit. I saw on the news they said that Falcons merch is flying now. So
right,
it's interesting to see, like, what happens to the city when their team goes to the Super Bowl. Yeah, well, we have a bandwagon now.
Right,
fresh bandwagon.
Y'all got mad celebrities showing up.
Atlanta.
Y'all have fucking who the fuck was there? Jermaine Dupri was there and shit like that.
He
was there by himself, and then he had his old braids next to him in an Atlanta Falcons hat.
Yeah.
it was a lot of shit going on. You got Future fucking sending Atlanta Falcons jerseys to his kid. Petty guy, but I fuck with that. I fuck with that. I fuck with that. You gotta do what you gotta do.
I bet you his son. Shit. What if you know, gotta do what you gotta do? Falcons fan.
So it's Matt Ryan versus Tom Brady though. Matt Ryan versus Tom Brady. That nigga gonna have to wait. We could.
Yeah, Matt Ryan, Tom Brady. Yeah.
It's a beautiful matchup, but we finna take a shit.
Yeah, we talking about.
And the thing is, it's I got a friend. We grew up together as far as like we played peewee football and shit like that and played against each other in high school. He played for the Patriots, so I almost feel obligated to root for him. But at the same time, Patriots always fucking winning, bro. Like y'all just was there last year, the year before that. Like,
and the last time we've been to a Super Bowl, dog, I was 9 years old. So.
Right. That,
I'm 27 now.
That's when everybody was doing that Dirty Bird.
Fuck the Patriots. Fuck the Patriots. And any team that was going against
them. Right.
It's gonna be a tough one, but go Falcons. Rise up.
Definitely. Black city versus definitely like a white culture.
Pretty much. Not to make it racial, but.
Hey, sometimes, yeah. I mean, sometimes that's all it gotta be. That's like a Republican team. Like, I don't really fuck with it. But,
Republican team.
You've been paying attention as far as like the inauguration and Trump and all that shit. So, what if Trump called you last week and was like, yo, I want you to perform?
If the check was right,
check gonna be
and
right.
I'm letting everybody know, hey, I don't support this dude, but you gotta support this check.
Right. Nah, the check was gonna be right. What's her name?
Who's gonna match this check?
Her name.
For me not to go.
What?
D.L. Hughley.
Michelle?
How much
like
you trying to put down
right.
for me not to go?
He said D.L.
I'm just playing.
Nah, yeah, they bash Chrisette Michelle for going, but she got $250 for that. Like,
see, but when you
that's
a
big check.
When your explanation is as I think her explanation of it is what made people mad.
Yeah, I'm.
The check ain't clear though.
I should have plugged you up.
Yeah. Oh, shit.
The check ain't clear.
But nah, like, I
this the coolest Mac about. Talking, by the
it's
way.
It's coolest Mac, by the way. But, like, I think your reaction is kind of what made niggas mad. Like, if you would have came out and said, nigga, that check, you feel me? Like,
right.
You would have been like, yeah,
been
bet.
Right.
Yeah. But that bullshit ass note in baby blue that nobody was trying to read. Like,
right.
It's a hard color to read. Baby blue on a white background. Don't do that to me. I think it's your explanation, you know? Like, that kind of got people.
Yeah, if she was a little bit honest, where it's like, yo, who else gonna pay me? Like you said, like, who else gonna give me this check?
To not do
For what, 10 minutes, maybe? 10 minutes of my time. Shake a few hands and go about my business. But, so, we getting that on record. Yeah, they been there. Like, yo, $250, I'm all right.
For the quarter piece?
Yeah.
For sure.
Definitely going down with that.
Yeah.
But even with that, like, how do you feel like with him being at the helm as far as, you know, of the country?
Hey, man, he's president.
Right.
So, either
find
a way to impeach him or ride this wave.
Right.
That's our only two options.
T-fuck around and get impeached.
I'm not like, you know, I don't like getting my energy riled up on and not doing nothing.
Right.
So it's like, if we can't do it, we got to do to make the change, man.
Right.
Look out for self.
I feel like it's a good time. He can, you know, I feel like he represents something bad, but I feel like we needed a wake up so now we can focus on the shit that we need to do to better ourselves and to create more leaders. Like, that's how I feel about that, but...
I'm be focused on politics. I'm focused on flashy. You know what I'm saying? Having jewelry. You know what I'm saying? Goddamn, we having jewelry. We having fun. You know what I'm saying? We having lightsabers.
You sound like a real nigga right now. You sound like a real fucking nigga.
Mom, I'm just playing. I do focus on politics. I just...
He not focused on the politics.
It's definitely a subject that you don't want to say too much on because right. someone's going to feel the opposite way, you right. know? So, it's just like, I stay out of politics a little.
Instead, y'all out here crashing weddings and shit. That's what y'all do.
Yeah, man.
We talk about that a little bit. Yeah. Like, how did that come together?
Wedding crashers?
Yeah.
I met him through this producer that we were working with mutually, and we just kind of hit it off top, and just it started with just us recording songs all the time, but we weren't like a group. We were just, and then one day he made UTD Infinity, and we were just like, yeah, we should do something with this.
Right.
He came up with the name Wedding Crashers. I hated it at first, but then I saw the way he spelled it, and I was like, oh, that's fly.
Why you hate it though?
I don't know. I just didn't like it at first. I don't know. But like I said, when I saw the spelling of it,
right,
then it was just like, okay, all right, this is fly. Like,
why you pick that name out of all names? You fuck with the movie that much, or?
Well, yeah, like we both kind of fans of the movie,
yeah, for sure.
But like, I mean, that was the first, initially, yeah, that was the first thought. But then, like, when you kind of get smoke a blunt and try to delve deeper and make it mean something,
right,
it's like, yo, this, it actually kind of means something, because, like, we are, like, wedding crashers of, like, everyday life, like,
right,
pulling up to parties that we don't belong to. Yeah. Coachella, All Access.
Yeah.
You feel me?
Pretty much.
Didn't get the ticket to that day. You did what I'm saying? Like, one day shit. You feel me? Like, pulling up to different spots and shit, like, yeah, getting in for free, and you would never
think. Barclays Center.
The Barclays Center at a fucking New Year party, suit and tie with Nike Tech Fleece on. Like, that's how
that's
you crash
right
shit.
There.
You feel me? Like, we you know what I'm saying? Like, everything. That's how you come through, you feel me? And
it's more of a lifestyle.
It's the same thing with the UTD, the Up Through There, you know what I'm saying, campaign. Like, we up through there, we crash and shit. People don't want us there, we're not invited, but
right,
we're here smiling in your face and throwing our hoods up, you know what I'm saying? So that's what
and fucking their hoes. Yeah. I understand it. Yeah. Yeah. I understand it, definitely understand it. And y'all got 13-17, if I'm correct.
Yeah,
13-17. Talk about that a little bit as well.
It's just nice numbers.
Ain't no nice numbers.
It's
that
just some
something.
Nice numbers.
That means something. Nice numbers is
gang.
Nice numbers is a million.
Right.
250 is a nice number, right?
That's how a long way would have answered it. It's just I just like the number. I'm just playing. It was just our homegirl's apartment unit number. And we just turned it to a thing.
Shout out to Trees.
Shout out to Trees.
Shout out to Trees. That's dope. She getting a check from this show? You cut her?
Of course, man.
Oh, all right.
Triselda Blanco.
Triselda Blanco. She's going to demand a check.
Yeah.
I'm just saying. Just saying. You really fuck with Star Wars, or you just liked it?
I fuck with Star Wars for sure. Yeah.
Y'all was geeking up there over it. Like, Nah, he dope as fuck though.
Yeah,
he
man.
He dope as fuck.
Yeah, bro's amazing. I'm my brother kind of raised me up on like comic book characters and stuff, like, so.
You're definitely gonna have to FaceTime him before you leave here.
Yeah. Well, he unfortunately has one of those Android things.
Oh, that's not a phone.
Damn.
Yeah. Like, his texts are like green and stuff. Like,
terrible color.
Yeah.
To like read like Chrisette Michelle.
That right? Like,
right. One white.
Come on, man. Reek, man. Dad, like, my whole family, like, get rid of those. Get some iPhones in your life.
How your family moving with your recent success and all of that shit, man?
Like, they be, I make them hold it in. They be wanting to be like excited and like,
you gotta
talk
let
about
them
all
know.
The time. But it's like, I don't want it to be like that when I go home. Like,
right?
I just want y'all to look at it like a regular job. Like, you know, I go out and I go to work just like my brothers go out and go to work. When I come back, like, you know, I don't want to be treated different, and I don't want to treat people different, you know?
So nah, I
try to make it a point to make sure my family, like,
some sort continue. Of normalcy.
Yeah.
Some sort of normalcy. Like, I get it. You, but at the same time, you do realize, like, the shit that y'all are doing,
I get
that shit
it, I
not
get
normal.
I get it.
My bitch is in the loop.
I get
His
it.
His mom's is in the loop.
Yeah, she's definitely in the loop, like,
all
for sure.
Right.
She definitely knows. And my mom knows every, man, from day one, like, my mom, she's my number one fan for sure.
Right.
So she knows everything that's going on. But I be making it, like, she asks me questions in segments. Like, you know, when I get home from the tour, she'll probably ask me, like, 10 questions. And then leave it alone.
And then come
about
back.
Stuff that she seen on the internet. Yeah. Like, so what about this?
Like, we find out she be reading your mentions and shit.
Oh, yeah, all that. All that. She be wanting to respond to people that be saying bad stuff. I be like, Mom, stop. Like, I don't even see those tweets. Like,
that's what moms be doing.
Yeah, that's moms, though. Love you, Mom.
Child nah, that's mom. That's dope. But yeah, it's definitely, the shit that y'all doing, bro. It's not normal, but you do need a sense of normalcy. So
for sure,
I get it,
for
and sure. you'll yeah. want it out of the people that you know yeah. you really exactly. that you love, that yeah. you genuinely love. Yeah. So, I get it. Yeah. But
I know they're happy for me though. So
right.
Yeah.
So, that's pretty much it. You got as far as like any announcements or something to make, man. Any well, announcements, what you got going on?
Gunmetal Grey Tour continuing. New York tonight. Atlanta on the 8th of February. And LA on, what's it?
We going to end February in LA.
Yeah. I think the 24th. The 24th in LA. February
24th. Tell them the website.
We got an LA run, actually. Website. A couple
of
days.
Oh, website. Plug 1317.com, but you spell the ones.
Yeah, I mean, listen, I got dumb listeners. I'll let you know that right now. Yeah. So you definitely gonna have to spell that out. Ain't not
so it's like O-N-E, the number 3, O-N-E, the number 7.com.
That's how you do it, bro.
Yeah.
They gonna be grateful for that.
Yeah, for tickets and shit, you know. And, Twitter, Instagram, all that stuff.
Nah, I appreciate you for coming on. I appreciate y'all for coming through the studio, man.
Appreciate you, man.
Get up out of here, man. Who you with? Enter Android Joystick's Teddy Star.